You need to seek therapy ASAP. And if you scroll down past all of the BS, you see that she's been hiding a lot of replies. Someone actually called her a cat killer and completely ratioed her. Please provide more information so I could put this in the threat too. He's referring to you. And you know, everyone's making fun, everyone's laughing, and then we get into this post. And even if this is fake, why would you want to be known as a cat killer? You know what I mean? But anyways, it just says, trigger warning, disturbing, my cats know, who has been vegan her entire life, ate my hamster while I wasn't home. As a cat lover, I am devastated. On my way to the vet so they could do
euthanasia.
And I am crying a lot, this hurts. STF humor.
Air. What are we supposed to do? Just sit here and wait for Mr. Peppy to be killed?
Sounds like a plan. Guess I'll pass the time by lighting up an El Jerko.
You are the effing cat killer. He's referring to you. If this is fake, what would you ever fake this for? The memes, for the interactions. You know what, it would be one hell of a plot twist if it actually does turn out this person's an insane cat killer. But she's hiding behind this whole I'm satirical, I'm rage bait. And if you take a look at their profile, it's pretty obvious what they're doing. But let me put my tinfoil hat on. What if this is an actual cat killer? Or hell, maybe this is a baby killer on the loose and they're just pretending to rage bait people and being like, yeah, Mr. Beast abuses animals. But think about this. What if this is her cover-up and she's actually an insane, unhinged cat killer? You never know. That'd be one hell of a plot twist if it actually does turn out that she's this fucking insane person. I mean, making threats and spending all day on Twitter making fake posts to bait people in, it's already some kind of mental illness that should get you locked up. All right, so I was just looking at some DMs that I haven't answered. Who doesn't know how to sell a contradiction? You come and go, you come and go. Come, 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 chameleon. You come and go, you come and go. Twitter, by the way, follow me there. We're so close to 4,000 followers. I'd be really appreciated. And this person, in the morning, they sent me the same account. Thought I'll share because this shit is so retarded. Trigger warning, SA. We need to talk about the problematic concept of gooning and similar. Dear Gen Z, stop gooning, you know, virtual rave, the time to stop is long overdue, sincerely women. I am a little concerned that despite being on Twitter for less than a year, they already have close to 2,000 tweets, and they're tweeting every 12 minutes.
So, Dinesh thinks this is you?
Correct. He's been messaging with it all day and he has no idea. It's an AI.
Well, we fooled a human. I guess we just passed the Turing test.
Almost a human.
Fucking Guilfoyle. We're friends.
You trained a thing in a day?
I didn't train it. Son of Anton did.
Son of Anton?
An homage to a fallen friend. It's the name that I've given our new inference API. He's indexing all of PiperNet as we speak, and he's starting to recognize intent, emotion, causality.
Hang on, wait.
Ground. Good point. What do you say we just hit a strip joint? I was waiting for one of us to say that. Bender A, you're a prince among robots. Can you forgive me for distrusting you? Oh, I can't stay mad at what is essentially me. I love me. Don't even.
How many times do you tweet per day? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that's not even the replies. If you look at the replies, yeah, it's a lot of tweeting. And it's like, is it really sarcastic at this?
I'm sorry, Fry, but some games you just can't win.
Bender doesn't care about us anymore. Someone used to care about me? Hooray!
Destroying the boy is just icing on the cake.
No one destroys a boy like you, Mother.
Thank you!
Order! Order in the head!
I'm sorry, guys. I didn't realize I was late. Hubert Farnsworth cannot be tried twice for the same crime.
What? I'll be a nugget's uncle. He's right.
What a brilliant legal shenanigan. Case dismissed.
If I can't bring down Farnsworth, I can at least dumb down his robot.
Why did you come back?
Honestly, I couldn't think of one good reason.
Leela!
Leela who?
It's good to see you. Is it good to see me?
Of course. Please, tell me, if Fry and I ended up together...
It's too late, Leela. He's good old Bender again.
Fry and Leela's ultimate fate by Bender.
It's probably better if we don't know.
And going back to the Mr. Beast thread, because it's so fucking silly, I thought we'll just take a quick look at it. He's treating them like slaves, using them for a quick cash grab on his YouTube channel. They don't deserve this. Here's Mr. Beast.
But they're not, because they're too busy.
So? What of it?
My fellow Leaguey Weegies, the time has come to overthrow humanity!
Oh, now, Bender, I hate to defecate on your parade, but we have only 6 dues-paying members, and we're a rather fey and doughy lot. To overthrow humanity, we need a damned army.
Then a damned army we shall have!
I rather think we could strike a deal, Bender. I shall give you your army of the damned. And in return, I ask just one thing. Just one itty-bitty thing.
Your firstborn son.
Just a sec.
Daddy, I knew you'd come back.
Here you go.
Wow! That was pretty brutal, even by my standards.
No backsies. Too long have we been...
He's trying to assault one of the dogs? This might be Mr. Beast's downfall. This is the end of the Mr. Beast channel. And what blows my mind is the fact that there's people who actually support this. But I have seen some people fall for this. I fell for the bait. I'm sure a few... 100 people saw it. I mean, how many views did the post get? Almost 800,000. I'm sure at least a few hundred. They were like... Holy shit. I think I found the best explanation for this account. I think this girl shoves a kilo of the good stuff up up her nose before posting a tweet. She seems to forget that she ended her cat's life for not being vegan. Mr. Beast is truly exposed now. I mean, there's already a shit ton of Mr. Beast hate on the app for no reason. Just something I wanted to talk about quickly because this shit's way too stupid not to be talked about. Okay, as soon as I was ready to pack it up and go home, go to bed. Well, not too bad because it's like barely 4 p.m. for me. But I see this from December 29th. Why does the Latinx community love Mr. Beast so much? I sincerely apologize to the Latinx community. No, I bet the comment section here is a war zone. Let's see what we got. Hey, it's Latino, not Lion X. Actually, Lion X is the correct and more inclusive term. Not gonna lie, this video has been so fun to film. This video genuinely feels like I'm just having some fun with some friends after a few drinks and we're just like, yo, what the fuck is... I can't with this. And then this person says, I am Latino, not Lion X, you son of a bitch. Don't mess with okay, this guy's going a little too crazy. I just had a thought. What if this person is genuinely a fucking cat killer and I'm out here laughing? Now I'm kind of scared. And I'll see you guys next time, my Lion X members.
's something that I think is going to be quite important, and it's there's not an, I don't know of a company that's working on it seriously is a neural lace. So okay, going back to the AI situation, this is quite an important debate. Like the. If you assume any rate of advancement in AI, we will be left behind by a lot. And so then we could be in, like, you know, benign situation, but even the benign situation, if you have some, you know, if you have ultra-intelligent AI, we would be, you know, so far below them in intelligence that it would be like, you know, a pet, basically.
Pet, that's what I was thinking.
Like a pet.
Cat.
Elon it'd be like a house cat. Yeah, right. It would be like the house cat.
Right.
Yeah, it's not the end of the world, you know. It's sort of pet.
You've seen the movie, it could be.
Yeah. It could be. That would be the benign scenario. Mm-hmm. So
house cat is okay.
I mean, I don't love the idea of being a house cat.
Okay.
But
what's the solution?
Yeah, so I think the one of the solutions, the solution that seems maybe the best one, is to have an AI layer. If you think of like you've got your limbic system, your cortex, and then a digital layer, a sort of a third layer above the cortex. That could work well and symbiotically with you. I mean, just as your cortex works symbiotically with your limbic system, your sort of a third digital layer could work symbiotically with the rest.
This is something that's surgically inserted or bred into the species or what?
The fundamental limitation is input-output. So we're already a cyborg. It's just that, I mean, you have a digital version of yourself or partial version of yourself online in the form of your emails and your social media and all the things that you do. And you have basically superpowers in that with your computer and your phone and the applications that are there. You have more power than the President of the United States had 20 years ago. Like you can answer any question. You can video conference with anyone.
Right.
Anywhere, you can send a message to millions of people instantly. You know, you can just do incredible things. And but the constraint is input output. So we're I/O bound, particularly output bound. I mean, like your output level is so low. It's like particularly on a phone, like your two thumbs are sort of tapping away. This is ridiculously slow. Our input is much better because we have a high bandwidth visual interface to the brain. Like our eyes take in a lot of data. So there's many orders of magnitude difference between input and output. So mostly, effectively merging in a symbiotic way with digital intelligence revolves around eliminating the I/O constraint. So it'd be some sort of direct cortical interface.
And you called it a neural lace?
Neural lace, yeah.
It's totally not Google Glass, right?
No, okay. I'm talking about something
which... No, but it's like you wear it?
No, I mean it would be... there are a few ways to approach this, but some sort of interface directly with your cortical neurons particularly.
But doesn't that imply surgical insertion?
Not necessarily. You could go through the veins and arteries because that provides a complete roadway to all of your neurons. Your neurons are very heavy users of energy, so they need high blood flow. So you automatically, with your veins and arteries, have a road network to your neurons.
Still some kind of surgery, right?
Yes, but you could insert something, you know, basically, you know, into the jugular and have, it gets macabre, but
it sounds, I mean, really easy and
it doesn't involve risk-free. It doesn't involve, you know, like chopping your skull off or anything like that.
That's good.
Yeah.
And plus, you're not a house cat anymore.
With the new iPhone, you can watch, listen, ignore your friends, stalk your ex, download porno on a crowded bus, even check your email while getting hit by a train. All with the new iPhone.
From mom.
A new iPhone? Forget this junk.
Well, this is a fine how do you do.
So long.
Sayonara.
Bye-bye.
Good riddance.
Yep. Toodaloo.
Come on, let's buy some iPhones online.
Wait, I thought we were buying our iPhones online.
We are online.
But I thought the mom store was across town.
It is across town.
But I thought...
Stop thinking, Fry.
I feel like a mindless zombie. I wish I knew how long we've been waiting.
The iPhone has an app for that.
Is there an app for kissing my shiny metal ass?
Several.
Ooh.
Oh no, the light. I guess I'm off to hell.
That's the store, Professor.
You are?
That's constantly playing everywhere.
Hello, dearies. Welcome to the Mom Store. The new iPhones are in short supply, so please form an orderly...
Out of the way!
Are there any left?
There may be one. Okay, it's $500. You have no choice of carrier. The battery can't hold a charge, and the reception isn't very...
Shut up and take my money!
The new iPhone is wonderful. I use it to check recipes and send threatening emails to unauthorized third-party app developers.
Say, you're from one of those ethnicities that knows about technology. Why is it called an iPhone?
I'll explain after I install it.
Neat.
Now for the earpiece.
But my favorite app is called Twitcher. Twitcher lets you send and receive short messages or videos called twits. Why, here's a twit now.
Hi, Mom. I love you more than care.
Low battery.
But don't take my word for it. UnbiasedReviews.mom says Twitcher is the killer app.
And when I say killer app, I mean killer app.
Here it is, folks. This video was...
With the new...
Here it is, folks. This video was...